As na-mention ko na po, ayan, so it's already 7:12, so let's start po. Let's, thank you, Jocelle Sara, sa 50 pesos na super sticker, the Starry Nights. Okay. Teka lang, set up ko muna. So, ayan. Okay, isang mapagpalang gabi po sa inyong lahat, no? Sir Melvin Boracho here for the part 4 ng ating final drills sa professional education. Sana po ay nasa magandang lugar kayo kung saan pwede nyong ito ang lahat ng pansin ninyo sa ating tatalakayan tonight because we are going to discuss Prof. Ed and you know Prof. Ed, it takes a lot of your energy, lalo na po sa mga tanong na hindi pamilyar sa inyo. So, I will teach you how to answer and attack them in the sense that hindi masyadong mahirap, no, sa mga ordinaryong estudyante yung pamamaraan na gagawin natin. And to start with, no, sources natin, marami, okay, self-made questions, and then meron ding from MCQ, no, na marami din silang presentang mga questions na pwede nyo pong pag-aaralan. And then sa libro ko pong napili, no, kay Reyes, et al. Curriculum Development no, ng 2015 edition and also Facebook posts related to Prof. Ed na napakarami din po mga mali, lalo na sa online. Ano? So, kailangan natin silang i-rationalize, ipaliwanag para at least malinaw ang utak ninyo pagpasok nyo sa test-taking room. No copyright infringement intended. All questions, methods, and techniques belongs to the rightful owner for educational purposes only. Okay. So, let's go. Again, ulitin ko po, no? Ang magiging savior mo during the day sa inyong board examination in Prof. Ed ay eto talaga itong quote na ito. So, huwag kayong kalimutan na dapat i-master nyo kung paano maghanap ng context clues and then i-master nyo rin yung paghahanap ng kakaiba doon sa apat na choices. To do that, remove items or remove choices that you think, no, not part of the correct answer. Huwag kang sagot agad, dapat tanggalin muna ang obvious distractors. Okay? Anticipate, so you have studied very well, kailangan mong anticipate, kailangan mong gumawa ng intelligent guess, no? Paano ba natin gawin 'yan? Basahin ang question and then try to guess, try to recall everything that you have studied and try to say a correct answer that you think. Okay? Tapos hanapin sa choices. Kapag nandun siya, do not anymore spend your time reading the other choices, 'di ba? Kasi naaral mo na 'yan, kasi naalala mo na nag-guess mo siya. What about for the best clue is on the stem? Yan po ang lagi nating sinasabi. Ano? Hindi po lalabas ang kasagutan diyan sa tanong. So, ibig sabihin, ang pinaka-guide mo, ang compass mo on getting the correct answer, nandyan lamang po sa stem ng question, given na naiintindihan mo yung question. Okay? Sir, paano kung hindi ko naiintindihan ang question? That's the time that you're going to touch add one out, no? And also, yes, yun lang po yung pwede mong gamitin, no? Kapag hindi mo alam yung tanong, lalo na pag gumamit siya ng mga salitang hindi ka naman pamilyar. So at least, alam mo kung paano siya atakihin. So again, kapag naman po naiintindihan ang tanong, you have to answer it using the context clues na makikita doon sa stem ng katanungan. Tandaan mo, sa Prof. Ed, ang best clue para sa pinaka-the best na tanong, I mean sa pinaka-the best na sagot, ay nandiyan lamang po sa katanungan. You just have to find that word or words para magiging guide mo doon sa tamang sagot. Okay? Find those words. Nandiyan lamang yan at tuturuan ko kayo kung paano i-apply yan sa actual questions later. So, let's go. By the way, gusto ko lamang pong formal na magpasalamat sa inyo dahil sa araw na to na abot natin ang another milestone ng YouTube channel na ito, we were able to hit, guess what? The 200,000 subscribers. So, buhay ang mga ayan, nangangarap na magiging isa sa kanilang profession. Maraming salamat po at naway hindi kayo magsawang sumuporta sa akin at sa channel na to para ipagpapatuloy natin ang advokasyang para po sa mga walang-wala talaga sa buhay na kailangan din po nilang ipasa ang board exam. Walang maiiwan, lahat po ng aking gagawin dito, ililibre natin, load lamang po yung isasagot mo dyan kapag nakapublic po ang ating broadcast. Maraming salamat po and let's try to start na with the first question para at least hindi na kayo mabagot dyan kung saan ka man ngayon nakaupo or nanunood. So once again, just sit back, relax, and of course, answer. Kasi hindi po pwede na mag-aantay ka lang dyan sa tamang sagot. You have to cope with, no? The momentum, you have to cope with the pressure na kailangan mong i-undergo during the actual examination na sasabakan mo, okay? So, let's go. Unang katanungan agad tayo sa professional education. Again, in answering Prof. Ed, i-quote muna natin yung katanungan. Let's go. Number one. When small children call all animals dogs, what process is illustrated based on Piaget's cognitive development theory? Again, when small children, ang mga bata raw, tinawag ang lahat ng hayop na aso, what process is illustrated based on Piaget's CDT? Okay, state muna natin yung apat na CDT ni Jean Piaget. Sensor, pre-op, concrete, and formal. Okay, so pag sinasabi nating age 0 to 3, that's sensor. Pag sinasabi nating 3 to 7, that is pre-op. Pag sinasabi nating 7-11, that is concrete. Pag sinasabi nating 12 and up, that is formal, operational, di ba? So now, let's go to the context clues. Nandyan sa katanungan. Which word should you underline? Which word should you underline? Tandaan nyo na ang booklet ninyo, pwede nyo po siyang sulatan para sa mga clue na nakikita ninyo sa katanungan. So, kung yan ang tanong na makikita mo, ano ang i-underline mo dyan? Very good. Call all animals. Diba? So, merong nangyayaring generalization kung si Pavlov ang atin pong pagbabasehan. Pero again, si Piaget kasi yan, kaya under siya sa category ng assimilation. Bakit? Sir, bakit? Ganito yan. Kapag po ang utak natin, nagkakaroon siya ng storage, yung schema kung tinatawag, kapag may papasok na impormasyon, and then yung impormasyon in-integrate ng bata sa lahat ng kanyang makikita, that is assimilation. In this case here, di ba, nasa schema niya yung aso, kaya tinawag niya lahat ng hayop na aso. Okay? What about if matutunan ng bata na hindi pala lahat ng may apat na paa or hindi lahat ng animals ay aso, and then nag-adjust yung schema niya, that's the time that we can call it accommodation. I hope malinaw yung mga ganyan. Ang conservation po, saan siya kabilang, sir? Sa concrete operational na yan. Okay? Paano ba? Okay, ang concrete operational kasi, pag sinasabi nating concrete, ibig sabihin, there is a logical reasoning for the child, no, observing a phenomenon. Example, yung mahabang baso at yung medyo malapad na baso, kung parehas yung content nila ng tubig pero dahil lang sa shape, nagkakaiba sila. Kapag nasabi ng bata na parehas lang po sila kahit magkaiba yung size nila. I mean, parehas lang po sila. Kaso lang, etong isa mataba, etong isa medyo mahaba. So kapag meron ng ganyang reasoning ang bata, siya ay nasa conservation na. Pero paano sir kung hindi niya kayang i-identify yan? Nasa deconservation pa lang siya, nasa centration pa lang siya. Hindi niya kayang mag-reason out. Another po sa concrete operational ay ang tinatawag nating reversibility. Ano bang ibig sabihin ng reversibility? Okay, in math, sabihin natin, 1 plus 2, 3. Kapag meron ng reversibility skill ang bata, pwede niyang masagot ang 2 plus 1 equals 3. Okay? Kuha. The same with seriation. Kapag po kaya nang i-order ng bata, no, ang mga bagay-bagay mula maliit, patung malaki, mura malaki, patung maliit, that is seriation. Pero kapag hindi niya kaya, that is deseriation. Nasa pre-operational pa lang siya. So kung titingnan nyo, sa sensory, senses, lahat ng nakikita. So the question here is all about senses that belongs to what? Sensory motor. Pero kapag pre-operational na, medyo gumagana na dyan yung yung animation, no, kung tinatawag sa mga bata yung si Mr. Moon, si Mr. Sun, no, gumagalaw-galaw sila, tapos yung mga Marvel characters, dyan papasok ang tinatawag nating pre-operational. Okay, sa concrete operational naman po, dyan nila makuha ang skill na tinatawag nating reasoning, di ba? Reasoning. Pero kapag naman po sa formal, sir, kung may reasoning dyan sa abstract, sa concrete, formal naman po, higher order thinking skills, di ba? Oo. So meaning, kung kaya nilang i-differentiate ang medyo hindi ganun kakomplikadong bagay, dito sa formal operational, kahit gaano kakomplikado yan, kaya na nilang ipaliwanag. Okay? So, again, malinaw po ang katanungan dito na call all animals lamang po yung hinahanap. So, ibig sabihin, simple sensory motor lamang, and we are going to select letter A kasi nga po, siya ay under sa category niyan or sa konseptong niyan. Ayos? Next item tayo. Nakakuha ba? Nakuha, ayan, very good, no? So, madali lang ang katanungan na to. Next item. According to Tolman's theory, eto, maganda to. According to Tolman's theory on purposive behaviorism, learning is goal-oriented. What is its implication to teaching? Again. According to Tolman's theory on purposive behaviorism, learning is goal-directed. What is its implication to teaching? Diba? So, kung ikaw ang sasagot sa tanong na to, what word will you underline? Okay. What word will you underline? Oh, yung iba may problema. Kaya kayo nagkakamali dahil sumagot kayo agad nang hindi man lang sinabi yung words na kailangan yung i-underline. Diba? So yung mga nagkakamali diyan, sila yung sumagot agad. Now, ang i-underline natin dito ang salitang what? Purposive. Okay? Meron pa. At ang salitang goal-directed. Very good. So, pag sinasabi nating purposive, it is very obvious na nagtuturo ka raw para matuto ang bata. Diba? Again, nagtuturo ka para matuto ang bata. That is purposive behaviorism. Now, tingnan natin sa choices. Sino ba yung nagtuturo dyan para matuto ang bata? Let's go to letter D. Make the objectives of your lesson clear and specific. Nagtuturo ka na ba dyan? Hindi ba, di ba? Or even, tapos ka na bang magturo dyan? Hindi pa. So yung mga sumagot ng letter G dyan, pakisaktan yung sarili mo. Dahil hindi ka nag-iisip eh. Oo, sinabi mo agad yung sagot, hindi ka pa nga nakapag-underline, di ba? So letter D, ligwak na yan. Next, letter C, stick to your objectives no matter what happens. Well, given naman po na yung objectives mo will answer the what? The things that needs to be learned, no? In what you have discussed. So perhaps that is good, no? Although ang salitang no matter what happens is somehow compromising, no? Pero maganda po na mag-stick ka sa objectives mo. Pero again, hindi siya yung tinatanong. Diba? Letter B, set as many objectives as you can. Pwede naman, maraming objective, wala naman pong problema. Pero tingnan mo ang common between C, B, and D. Diba? Puro objective lang yung sinasabi nila. Kay purposive behaviorism, sabi dyan, ikaw ay nagtuturo para may pagkatutong magaganap. Now, let us try to see letter A. Evaluate lessons based on your objectives. Isn't that purposive? Diba? Purposive means nagtuturo ka for learning. And to measure learning, you have to evaluate. Diba? And to measure learning, you have to evaluate. And to evaluate, you need to go to your objectives. So, mali na, no? Nagkamali ka, that means you're learning. I hope that malinaw yan. So, ganito yan, teachers. Pag sinasabi natin purposive behaviorism, that is all about evaluating lessons based on your objectives. Okay? Pero kapag tinanong lang nila, ano yung mahalaga kay purposive behaviorism, hindi isagot mo agad objectives, pero dito kasi, binigyan ka ng kondisyon na learning is goal-directed. So, which should best fit no on this statement? May learning kasi. Kapag gumawa ka pa lang ng objective, wala pang learning dyan, ikaw pa lang po ang involved dyan. Diba? O again, ano nga yung SMART sa objectives? S for specific, M for measurable, A for attainable, R for result-oriented, and T for time-bounded. Ano lang ba lumalabas yan? Yung T, time-bounded. Okay? So, iba-iba sagot sa FB drills dyan, ha? At least nalinawan na ngayon. O, diba? Kaya, actually, sa Facebook to nakuha kong tanong na ang sagot nila letter D. Well, ipapaliwanag natin ng mas malinaw siguro dahil po ang tinatanong naman dyan is purposive behaviorism. And when you say purposive kasi, you teach with purpose. And what is that purpose? Learning. And how to measure learning? You evaluate. Diba? So I hope malinaw yan. So ngayon, hindi na kayo malilito kung makikita nyo ang tanong na to sa Facebook again. Okay? O, sagot nila letter D, di ba? Pero hindi po. That's letter A. Next. Maganda kasi tingnan si letter D. O, hindi lahat ng maganda. Maganda talaga. Next. Lisa's family had a family picture when she was not yet born. Unable to see herself in the family picture, she cried despite her mother's explanation that she was not yet born when the family picture was taken. What does Lisa's behavior show? Obvious, di ba? Hindi pa siya isinilang, tapos, ayan, nagwawala siya dahil wala siya sa picture. O anong klaseng behavior yan? Aha. Very good, no? That is egocentrism by Jen Piaget pa rin itong tanong na to, di ba? Pero kung i-relate natin siya kay Freud, ang tawag natin dito ay id, di ba? Id. or the animalistic attitude. So ulitin natin, the clue word that you can find on the question is or are, meron ba? No, it's contextual clues. Ibig sabihin, ano ba yung contextual clues? Kabuuan ng tanong yung magbibigay sa'yo ng clue kung ano yung tamang sagot based sa diwa ng katanungan. So, contextual clues po ang ating gagamitin dito. The correct answer here is egocentrism. Because ang iniisip niya, yung sarili niya, at wala ng iba. Hindi nakikinig ng rason. Bakit? Wala ako dyan. Hindi siya nakikinig. Basta't galit siya, di ba? Ayan. Next. So, ang sagot dito, that is letter B. Egocentrism. Based on Piaget's theory, what should a teacher provide in formal operational stage? O, di ba sabi ko kanina, ang pinaka mataas, no? Ang pinaka gurang, di ba? Yung pinaka mataas na age level kung saan pwedeng ma-develop ang isang bata ay sa formal operational, 12 to 15 ata ito. Or 12 and up, no? So, ano daw ang ipo-provide ni teacher sa formal operational stage. Sige. So, you underline the word formal operational stage. A, stimulating environment with ample objects to play with. Objects, play. Sensory motor yan. Let's rationalize po. Hindi po pwede na ang tanong na to, yung sagot lamang yung hahanapin natin. Ipapaliwanag natin ang choices dahil mahalaga siya for the other concepts, no? Stimulating environment with ample objects to play with. That is sensory motor. Games and other physical activities to develop motor skills. That is still what? Pwede niya siya for pre-operational, no? Naglalaro na ang bata dyan. Okay? And then, pwede rin siya sa sensory to develop, again, the motor skills, no? Yung pag-on ng TV, yung pag-open ng door, di ba? Pag-wipe ng window kapag hindi naman po masyadong mataas. Ano? So, activities for hypothesis formulation. Ang ganda, no? So, meaning you try to infer, no? Or try to create or synthesize, build up something out of your observation. Maganda to. Letter D. Learning activities that involve problems of classification and ordering. Wait, yung letter D na yan, saan siya kabilang? That's concrete operational. Obvious, di ba? Yung learning activities that involve problems, classifications, and ordering. O yung conservation at yung seriation. Diba? Yun yung pinunto sa letter D. So, hindi siya yung sagot. So, obvious naman po, diba? Na ang sagot sa formal operational is you try to make use of your abstract thinking, you make use of your synthesizing skills, you make use of the higher order thinking skills dito sa stage na to. So, ulitin natin, kapag sensory, senses, kapag pre-operational, animistic attitude, no? Yung gusto nilang magiging superhero sila. And then for concrete, yan, meron na silang problem-solving skills like classification and ordering. Pero kapag formal, abstract, hypothesis, synthesizing skills, covert thinking, mental thinking, that is it. Malinaw yan? I hope teachers, I'm just explaining in layman's term, in verbatim that everybody can understand. Okay? Next. O, tama yung sagot natin, letter C. Why is babyhood referred to as critical period in personality development? Why is babyhood considered critical period in personal development? Sige. Let's read the choices. Intindihan muna natin yung tanong. Bakit raw ang babyhood ni-refer siya na critical period, no? Sa personality development. Dito daw yung identifying factors, no? Kung anong magiging ang bata paglaki. A. At this time, the baby is exposed to many physical and psychological hazards. B. Changes in personality pattern takes place. C. At this time, the foundations are laid upon which the adult personality structure will be built. Letter D. The brain grows and develops at such an accelerated rate during babyhood. Which is the correct answer? Based on the presented question, babyhood. You underline the word babyhood. Ano yung mga kayang gawin ng isang baby, no? Or ano yung mga inundergo na changes ng isang baby? And then meron pang inad, personality development. Sus. Diba? In personality development, you know what's personality? The way how people see you, diba? That's why we have a lot of personality, I mean personalities in different situations, no? Lalo na kapag meron kang training dito, you can wear a lot of personalities. But bakit sa babyhood kinonsider siyang critical? Because again, the clue word there is foundations. Very good. No? Sa mga sumasagot dyan, foundations. Yes. No? So maraming nagkakamali. Ligwak na naman. It is the time that the foundations are laid upon which the adult personality structure will be built. Tandaan nyo po, bakit siya nagiging critical? Because ang mga pundasyon po ng kanyang mga nalalaman sa pagiging siya, paglaki niya, ay nandyan sa babyhood. Kaya yung pamangkin ko na inuutusan ko na, baby, itapon mo to sa basurahan. Baby, i-on mo ang light. Baby, isara mo ang pinto. Baby, magmano ka. Kasi nga po, dyan sa babyhood na yan, nangyayari yung kanyang pundasyon sa paglaki niya. Di ba? That's why hindi natin masisisi ang mga batang bayolente. Nung bata kasi yan, pinabayaan lang ano. Tapos nung paglaki, di natin maintindihan bakit ganyan mag-isip dahil po sa pundasyon yan. Sino pa ba rito ang hindi nagkakamali? Meron pa bang perfect 3 over 5 na karamihan? Yes. So underline the word babyhood and underline the word personality development. So babyhood, foundations, personality development, that's personality structure. Actually, class, no, you are just plotting or you're just what? Trying to look for the words that resembles the question. Personality development. Merong salitang personality structure, ano? Oo, structure development, no? That is it. Next. 4 over 5 na yung iba. Sige. So at least po, matataas yung score ninyo. Nakakita ko ng 5 over 5. Si Vince Jolvi, ayan, magaling to. So I suppose, makakikita tayo ng top-notcher dito, no? And also, get layo, get the ion. Ayan. Very good, no? Next item. Oy. Nasaan na yun? Ay, wag na yan. Okay. It is good to give students creative learning tasks because, again, it is good to give students creative learning tasks because A. Development is affected by cultural changes. B. The development of individual is unique. C. Development is the individual's choice. D. development is aided by stimulation. So then again, those are true for development. But then again, what is the main reason why you give students creative learning tasks? Sige nga. That is anchored to the theory of behaviorism, di ba? Bigyan mo sila ng creative learning task para ano? Ay, naku sila, oh. Basahin niyo, intindihin niyo yung tanong kasi, no, do not answer yet. Intindihin ang tanong, naku. Ligwak. Tingnan niyo, creative learning tasks. Bakit kailangan bigyan sila niyan? Very good, no? Because development is aided by stimulation behaviorism. Kapag binigyan mo na magandang activity ang bata, maganda rin yung performance niya, di ba? That is supposed in the theory of behaviorism. Because then again, no? They are stimulated by their environment. Subukan mo yung classroom mo, naka-pink lahat, o hyperactive ang lahat ng bata. Because again, behavior is influence, no, of its environment. Ligwak. Very good, ligwak no naman. O magbunyi ang taong bayan. No? Development is aided by stimulation. Kapag ang tanong, why is it good to give students differentiated learning tasks? Again, baguhin natin. Why do we give students differentiated learning tasks? That's the time that you're going to answer, individuals are unique. That's the time that you're going to answer, individuals are unique. Malinaw po ba? Again, read the question first. No? Do not right away go to the choices without even looking at the question. Kakamali ka dyan. Okay? So again, yung mga uniqueness din yung sagot, ganito naman yung tanong. It is good to give students differentiated. Kapag may salitang differentiated, kapag may salitang varied, kapag may salitang diversity, o yan, multiple intelligences yan. Uniqueness ang inyong titingnan dyan. Ayos? I hope malinaw yan. So the lesson that you're getting from this question is read the question first. Give what is asked. And you are not asked for individual differences. You are just asked for the behaviorism, no? The effect of giving them creative learning task. So in layman's term, magbibigay ka ng creative learning task for what? To aid stimulation of their development. Diba? Mm-hmm. Very good. Next item. According to Havighurst's development tasks or developmental tasks, reaching and maintaining satisfactory performance in one's occupational career is supposed to have been attained during sigurado ako, maraming magkakamali rito. Again, according to Havighurst's developmental tasks, reaching and maintaining satisfactory performance in one's occupational career is supposed to have been attained during blank. A, middle age and early adulthood. B, middle age. C, old age. D, early adulthood. Sige. Tingnan natin. Hello, good evening po sa inyong lahat. Bakit? Ano yung i-underline natin dyan? Havighurst's developmental task. And then, ano pa? Yung satisfactory performance in one's occupational career. Pero kailangan nyo pong ma-memorize ang developmental stages, no? Kung kailangan nyo pong sagutan to ng tama, kailangan yung i-memorize yun. Kasi nga po, intindihin. Okay? Intindihin. kung maaari kapag hindi kayang i-memorize. Sige nga, what's your clue? Sige. Very good, no? May mga nakakasagot pero maraming ligwak. Now, i-rationalize natin. Pag sinasabi natin developmental tasks according to Havighurst, eto po yun, no? Ayan. On your screen, nakikita nyo po yung age range, tapos ano yung kayang gawin nila. Sa infancy and early childhood, meron dyang learning to talk, learning to use the toilet, learning to talk, no, learning to form relationships with others. 0 to 5 yan. 6 to 12 naman po, dyan po yung school-related skills such as reading, learning about conscience and values. They also learn to be independent. Pag sinasabi naman natin adolescence, yan, role. Again, adolescence, role. Tandaan nyo po yan. Do they want emancipation for parents? No! Tandaan nyo po, kapag hinanap na adolescence tasks, developmental tasks, it does not include emancipation for parents. Malinaw? Yes, next. Early adulthood, choosing a lifetime partner. Okay? Establish a family, and then take care of a home, and then establishing a career. Listen to me. Yung mga sumagot ng letter A, establishing a career pa lang. Ano yung tanong kanina? Maintain satisfactory performance in one's occupational career. So kapag nag-i-establish ka pa lang, kakasimula mo pa lang dyan. But when you maintain, at what age bracket does that fall under? That's in, ayan, letter. Oo, yun, kuha nyo na po. Blur daw, hindi po yan blur, ano, sa inyo po yung end, no? Sa inyo po yung end. Okay? So, that is middle age. Maintain a standard of living. Perform civic and social responsibilities, maintain a relationship with spouse, and then adjust to physiological changes. So, nandyan po yung maintain a standard, no? And then perform civic, and then maintain a relationship, and then adjust to physiological changes. So, letter B is the correct answer, no? Middle age. Okay? Tandaan nyo po ang salitang satisfactory in one's occupational career, so you are building there a standard of your performance or of yourself in general. Okay, so that's Havighurst's developmental tasks. Okay, let's proceed. Kay 60, sir. Ayan, kay 60, maturity na yan, no? Adjust to deteriorating health, aging. Adjust to retirement. Walang babayarang tax. Meet social and civil obligations. Yan, magiging wisdom ka sa community mo. Adjust to loss of spouse. Oo, so magiging widow ka na dyan. Ano? So, yan. Next. O, yan yung middle age kasi yun yung sagot. O, ibigay natin. Achieving adult and civic responsibility. Assisting teenage children to become responsible and happy adults. Developing adult leisure time activities. Relating oneself to spouse as a person. Accepting and adjusting to the physiological changes of middle age. And then reaching and maintaining satisfactory performance in one's occupational career. And then adjusting to aging partners. Okay? And then, yun yung hinahanap, naka-underline siya or naka-box siya, reaching and maintaining satisfactory performance in one's occupational career. Okay? So, malinaw po ba? Kuha, that's letter B, ang sagot kanina. Let's go to the next item. O, sino pa bang walang ligwak dyan? O, yung mga walang ligwak, palakpakan mo yung sarili mo. Ibig sabihin, ang galing mo na. L. Ala, na po yung mga 7 over 7. Very good. So I am counting on you, no? And hindi po imposible na yung mga nagkamali dyan, magtatap din yan. There is no limit, no? On what you cannot and can do. So dapat chill lang. Dapat bigay todo lang kahit nagkakamali na. Okay? Yan. Pero yung iba na nakakatama, ang galing ninyo. Very good. Next item. A student says, I have to go to school on time. This is what the rule says. In what level of moral development is the student? I have to go to school on time, mama. This is what the rule says. In what level daw of moral development? Wait, by the way, sino tong moral development na to? Kuhlberg, very good. Pre-conventional, post-conventional. Conventional cannot be specifically determined. Sige. So sa pre-conventional, that's all about the idea of what is punished is bad and what is rewarded is good. So yung mga bata ninyo na gumawa ng mali, huwag niyong bigyan ng chocolate, huwag niyong bigyan ng kahit ano, dahil oo, tingin niya tama yung ginawa niya, i-punish niyo siya, okay? And then for conventional naman po, that's all about being a good girl and a good boy. And then that's all about law and order, okay? Law and order. Kapag naman po post-conventional, that falls under the social ethical principle and the social contract or the universal ethical principle or the social contract. So based dun sa sinabi ko, ano yung sagot? That's conventional. Very good. Letter C. Okay, sinong nakakatama? Ayan, marami. Kasi nga, ano pa, may dalawa pang tanong sa board related to moral development. Yung isa, yung bata raw, nakakita ng wallet, isinauli niya kay teacher para isauli ni teacher sa may-ari. Ano daw ang reasoning ng bata? Conventional. Pero naman po, kapag isang taxi driver o isang jeepney driver, nakita niya na merong naiwan ang isang pasahero, isinauli niya ito sa may-ari. Ano ang kanyang reasoning doon? Post-conventional. Dahil po, ayan, alam niya kung ano yung tamang gagawin. Doon kasi sa estudyante, we assume na gusto lang niyang ma-praise ng teacher. Kaya isinauli niya ang kanyang nakita. Or found na ano, na bagay na nawala, no? So that's it. Pag sinasabi nating law and order, i-drill nga natin. Pag sinasabi nating law and order, that's conventional. Pag sinasabi naman nating what is good is rewarded, that's pre-conventional. Pag sinasabi nating taxi driver is inauli, that's post-conventional. Pag sinasabi nating student mo is inauli niya yung nakita niyang wallet, that is conventional. Pag sinasabi nating universal ethical principle, post-conventional. Okay? Kaninong theory nga yan? Kay Kuhlberg. Lawrence Kuhlberg. Okay? Next item. In planning for instruction, can a teacher begin with assessment? In planning an instruction, can a teacher begin with assessment? Sige. Tingnan natin kung ano yung naaral ninyo sa assessment of learning ninyo. Yeah. Of course, marami pang nakaka-perfect dyan kasi nga po, madali yung number 8 natin. Sige. What about for this question? Can you start with assessment when you are planning for instruction? Oh, so papasok dito yung assessment for learning, di ba? Magbibigay tayo ng pre-test, magbibigay tayo ng diagnostic test, magbibigay tayo ng aptitude test. Okay? So, ang tamang sagot ay yes to determine entry, knowledge, or skill. Okay? Obvious po. So, again, pag-usapan natin yung pad-prefo. Pag sinasabi nating pre-test before you instruct, no, magbigay ka muna ng short quiz para at least makita mo yung progress. Pag sinasabi naman nating aptitude, i-measure mo kung magaling ba ang bata sa specific subject na to. So, ibig sabihin, aptitude measures the strengths. Okay? Kapag naman po i-measure mo ang weaknesses, oo, that is diagnostic. Malinaw po ba ang distinction? Kapag diagnostic, i-measure mo ang weaknesses, pero pwede rin nung nagpa-test ka ng diagnostic exam, makita mo yung strengths niya, makita mo yung weaknesses niya. Pero then again, kapag aptitude, strictly for strengths lamang yan. Kung magaling ba ang bata, dyan sa specific discipline na gusto mong i-test sa kanya. Another, kapag naman po placement, oo, that's all, that can be applied in knowing, no, the sectioning of the learners. And then formative assessment, that is the short quiz that you give during instruction. So again, class, pwede ba nating i-record ang short quiz? Pwedeng i-record, pero hindi pwedeng gamitin para sa pagbibigay ng grado. Ano lang yung pwedeng ibigay sa grado? Summative quiz or long quiz. Yung short quiz mo, that is only for mastery. How come na inirecord mo siya sa grado ng bata? So, hindi po pwede yan. Ha? Huwag nyong gayahin yung teachers natin sa elementary na ire-record yung quiz na after the discussion. Hindi po pwede yan. Mastery pa lang yan. Bakit nakaka-apekto na yan sa grado natin? Okay? So, that is recorded but not graded, no? Hindi siya maka-apekto dapat sa ating assigning of grades or tinatawag nating evaluation, judging of students' performance. So, i-drill natin yung assessment of and as and for. It is the integral part of the teaching and learning process. Of, what about it is given before instruction? For, what about after instruction? Of, what about for summative test? Of, what about for achievement test? Of, what about for board examination? Of, what about for short quiz? For, what about for reflection papers? As, what about for CPD? As, what about for self-directed learning? As, okay? So, malinaw po ba ang ating mga for, as, and of na yan? Very good. So, next item tayo. Wala pang nagkakamali. Ayan, ang sarap sa mata. Which of the following is closest to the real human digestive system for study in the classroom? Again, which among the following is closest to real human digestive system for study in the classroom? Pictures, model, the human digestive system projected, an overhead projector, or drawing? Obvious naman to, model, okay? Model. Pero kapag natatanggal-tanggal, that is what you call mock-ups. Mock-ups, okay? Pero kapag sa tanong na to, yun lamang yung binigay dyan, so siya yung sagot, okay? Models. Mas maganda kapag meron talagang nahahawakan ng bata dyan, di ba? Ito yung atay, ito yung kidneys, ito yung puso, ito yung tendons, ito yung ligaments, ito yung utak. Oh, mas maganda kapag ganyan, di ba? Models. Very good. Next. Which one is in support of greater interaction? Which one is in support of greater interaction? So you underline the word greater interaction. A, probing. B, repeating the question. C, not allowing a student to complete a response. D, selecting the same student respondents. Ito pang isa na to. Probing, rephrasing, prompting, at redirecting. Ano yung pagkakaiba nila? Pag sinasabi natin probing, you are what? You are trying to guide the student to elicit a performance. You are trying to guide a student to give you an answer. Prompting naman po, you are telling the student that you cannot accept and I don't know answers. That's why you have to answer. Prompting yan. Rephrasing naman po, iniba mo lang yung tanong sa lingwaheng na iintindihan ng bata. Elaboration. Okay? Kapag naman po redirecting, hindi na iintindihan ni teacher ang tanong. Kaya, i-redirect mo muna. Ganyan, sige. Ano yung ginawa ni teacher na ibinigay niya ang tanong doon sa mga bata dahil nag-iisip pa siya? Redirecting. Binago ni teacher yung tanong using the verbatim. That's rephrasing. Kapag naman po, malungkot ka, masaya ka, because that's probing. Kapag naman po, I cannot accept and I do not know answer, you have to answer. Yun yung mga strictang mga teacher. That is prompting. Very good. I cannot accept and I do not know answer. Next. O, saan sagot dito? Letter A, which promotes greater interaction? Probing, of course. Ayan. Next. I want to use a pre-teaching strategy that will immediately engage my students in the content and will enable me to get an insight into how students think and feel about the topic which is most appropriate. Storyboarding, KWL or know, want to know and learn chart, graphic organizer or document analysis. Mga tanong na ito, napakadali, no? Underline the words. Mm-hmm. How students think and feel. Oy, obvious ba? Letter A, very good, no? Know, want to know, and learn chart. Oh, that's the best pre-strategy technique, no? Pre-teaching strategy that you can give opportunity to learners to share how they're feeling and what do they think about the topic. Let's go to the next item. Letter A po yan. Napakabilis. Napakadali. Okay? Next. For a discussion for a topic from various perspectives, it is best to hold on a... Oh, eto na yun. Again, for discussion of a topic from a various perspective. Oh, various daw. So, it is best to hold A, debate, B, brainstorming, C, panel discussion, D, symposium. Maraming magkakamali rito. Sige nga. Obviously, it's not symposium, di ba? Kasi sa symposium, mga expert and specialists lamang po ang nag-uusap dyan related to a topic. And another, it's not brainstorming, because in brainstorming, what? You are trying to generate solutions to a problem. Okay? Again, in brainstorming, you are trying to generate solutions to a problem. On the question kasi, topic from various perspectives. Ah, so, sir, debate yan. Okay. Sir, panel discussion yan. Which is which? Again, ang symposium po, experts and specialists discussing a certain subject. So, hindi siya pwede. Dahil hindi po, wala naman pong experts. Kung merong experts na binanggit dyan, siya yung sagot. What about for brainstorming? You are trying to generate solutions to problems. So, brainstorming is not part of the question. I mean, it's not part of the possible answers. Okay? Letter A, debate. Letter C, panel discussion. Kapag ito yung magpapapasa or magpapatap sa'yo, which answer should you go for? Sige, tingnan natin ang mga nag-comment. Maraming letter C. Meron ding letter A. Sino kaya ang makakatama rito? Ano? The correct answer is, class, pag sinasabi nating debate, ang tanong dyan, two opposing teams discussing a certain issue that needs to be resolved. Again, pag sinasabi nating debate, two, the clue word there is two opposing teams. So hindi siya yung sagot. Panel discussion. Very good. Ayan. Nakakasagot ba ang taong bayan dyan? Okay, very good. Ayan, natawa yung iba. Panel discussion. Yes, the correct word is panel discussion. Discussing, obvious ba? Discussion. Discussion of a topic from various perspectives. I-drill natin. Again, two opposing teams. Debates. What about creating solutions to problems? Brainstorming. What about for experts talking a certain subject? Symposium. What about for discussion from a various perspectives? Panel discussion. Ligwak. Pero marami pa rin. Nakakatama. Very good. Tingnan natin kung tama ba yung sagot natin. Tadaan. Letter C. Tama. Letter C. Next. Next, next, next. The teacher is the first audiovisual aid in the classroom. That's why you cannot be replaced with technology, correct? What does this imply? The teacher is the first audiovisual aid in the classroom. What does this imply? A. You take care that you follow the fashion or else students won't listen to you. Dapat daw up-to-date yung kas mga kabuuan. up-to-date yung kas mga trends. Ano? Letter B. Your physical appearance and voice should be such that students are helped to learn. Letter C. Make good use of the radio and TV in the classroom. D. Include singing in your teaching method. Mm-hmm. Again, teacher daw is the first audio, naririnig, visual, nakikita. Look for that or look for the synonyms doon sa mismong choices. Visual, nakikita. Okay? And then, audio, naririnig. Letter A, dalawa yung criteria natin. Audio and visual. Letter A. You take care that you follow the fashion or else you won't, your students won't listen to you. What? Wala naman pong sinasabi dyan na audio or visual. Wala. Letter A, ligwak. Letter D. Include singing in your teaching method. Singing. Wait, audio lang yan. Audio. Okay? Man. Letter C. Make good use of radio and TV in the classroom. Wait. Teacher is the first audiovisual. Hindi po pwedeng gumamit si teacher agad ng TV at radio dahil si teacher ang ni-refer sa question. Okay? While tama naman po na ang TV visual, ang radio audio, pero ang tinutukoy kasi si teacher, hindi po yung mga technological tools. Letter B. Your physical appearance, nakikita, and voice, naririnig, should be such that students are helped to learn. Diba? Sharog marong pamiani. So, okay. So, teachers, did you see the trend or did you see the ease in looking for the correct answer when you find clues? Diba? I-underline mo yung audiovisual tapos si teacher, makikita mo na agad ang diwa ng gusto niyang ipaabot sa'yo. Ang gusto niyang ipasagot sa'yo na si teacher daw yung una, hindi po pwede gumamit ng iba pa kasi si teacher ang first audiovisual, di ba? So, obvious na letter B yung sagot. Very good. Ligwak ang iba pero karamihan nakakatama. I'm so happy for you guys, no? Next. Oh, tama yung sagot natin. Letter baby. Next. A teacher would use a standardized test. To blank. A teacher would use a standardized test to blank. A. To serve as a unit test. B. To serve as final examination. C. To engage in easy scoring. D. To compare her students to national norms. Obvious. The clue word there is standardized test. The clue word there is standardized test. When you give standardized test, what's your purpose? Or what is the reason behind? To engage easy scoring, dali ra kuno chikan because na answer key. To serve as a unit test, assessment of learning. To serve as final examination. Oy, yung iba ha, nagkakamali pa rin. Unit test at final examination, pareha silang assessment of learning. Bakit siya yung sinagot ninyo? Letter A and B are obvious non-correct answers. Letter C, to engage in easy scoring. Ay, teacher, hindi dapat easy scoring yung ina-after mo. Okay? Ang after mo dapat para malaman kung gaano ba kagaling ang bata as compared doon sa national norms. So, ibig sabihin, this is a criterion reference test. This is a criterion reference test. This is to compare to students to the national norms. That's why standardized tests are given. One of the examples of standardized test is National Achievement Test, kung saan binibigyan tayo ng answer key. Noon, nakakatawa lang ano, may problema talaga, no? Kasi nga ako binibigyan tayo ng answer key noon. So that is letter D. Very good. Next. Lita wants to help her students retain new information. Which one will she use? Lita wants to help her students retain new information. What or which one will she use? A. Questions. B. Mnemonics. C. Games. D. Simulations. Gusto nyo raw maalala yung information. What do you use? Paborito to ni Sir Melvin. Paborito to ni Sir Melvin. The correct answer is mnemonics. Very good. Ano yung simulation, sir? Replication. Ano yung simulation? Replication of the real thing. Ano naman po yung contrived experiences? Those are fake experiences. Again, those are fake experiences. Kapag, again, simulation, that is replication. What about for mnemonics? O, yun yung JIRP, Pepa E, Robert Dungney. Yun yun. Okay? O, malinaw. Yes, very good. That's letter B. O, di nagkakamali dahil napakadali. Next. Teacher Lolita, a teacher for 40 years. Nako, kaya nyo ba magtagal ng ganyan? Refuses to attend seminars. Ayun, lumalaki na ang ulo. She claims that her 40 years of teaching is more than She claims that her 40 years of teaching is more than all the seminars she asked to attend. She is asked to attend. Is her actuation and thinking in accordance to the code of ethics for professional teachers? A. No, a professional teacher, regardless of teaching experience, ought to go through continuing professional education. B. No, non-attendance to seminars means no professional growth. C. Yes, because she has taught for 40 years and may have mastered the trade. Letter D. Yes, provided that she has an excellent performance rating. Wala bang sasagot ng D, ng C? Very good, no? Regardless kung gaano ka nakatagal sa profession, you have to attend. Why? Because learning is a continuous process. Learning is, non-stop. Hindi siya tumitigil. The moment that you stop, that means you are 6 feet below the ground. So teacher, kahit 50 years ka na sa serbisyo, you still have to attend seminars because again, number one, that will help you grow. Number two, kailangan mo ng CPD units. CPD, 10912, 15 units ang kailangan nating makuha sa CPD. Next. Answer doon ay letter A. Obvious naman po. Letter A. Next. Is it ethical on the part of the teacher to proselyte in her classroom every Friday? Kanang mangonvince ba ni ang proselyte na? Proselyte, mangonvince. Okay. Or promote lagi, mangonverter ba? mangumberter, di ba? Naamtay mga kauban ani sa trabaho nga mangumberter sa tuag relihiyon. A, yes, that strengthens values education. B, yes, that is religious instruction which is allowed by the Constitution. C, no, a teacher shall not engage in promotion of his or her religious interest in the classroom. D, no, proselyting is no longer necessary in this age. Sige. Yes, that strengthens values education. Teachers, that's unknown, no? That's very good distractor, yung letter A na yan. Pero again, you are not allowed to force your values to be followed by others. Okay? No, teachers shall not engage in promotion of his or her religious interest in the classroom. Okay? Because again, the separation of church and state is inviolable. The same applies to teachers teaching in public schools. Nganong ang private schools, naaman na sir, naaman na sila yung agreement. Okay? And once you are going to integrate religious education, make sure nga naay written consent ang parents. Naay written consent ang parents. Okay? So that's letter C. No, a teacher shall not engage. Because if you engage, it is unethical. Okay? Malinaw po ba? Yes, that's letter C. Religious instruction is not explicitly allowed. Oo, it can be introduced, but given the permission of the parents or direct guardians. Okay? Letter C po ang tamang sagot. Yes, the same with the catechism. Ang kanilang mga catechist, dapat na sila ay approval. Okay? Sa principal, kanang mga estudyante nga moadto sa usa ka public school, naman na sila ay approval nga mauna. Okay? Given sad nga kanang musulod sila Catholics tanan or members of the same denomination, pero kung dili gani, you should ask for the permission of the parents. Ayos? Okay, so next item. Which can promote national pride among pupils and students? Which can promote national pride among pupils and students? A. Studying the lives of outstanding Filipinos here and abroad. 2. Reading the lives of saints of the church. 3. Studying Philippine history with emphasis on the victories and greatness of Filipino people. Again, which can promote national pride? Oh, underline the word national pride. That's, is it 1, 2, and 3? Is it 3 only? Is it 1 and 2? Or is it 1 only? Studying the lives of outstanding Filipinos here and abroad, does that promote national pride? Reading the lives of saints of Catholic Church? Of saints of church, does that promote national pride? National pride is for our history itself, with emphasis on the victories and greatness of our people. That is letter B. Oh, walang ligwak, very good. Ayan, puro. History books used in schools are replete with events portraying defeats and weaknesses of the Filipino people. In the spirit of nationalism, how should you tackle them in the classroom? Again, history books used in schools are replete with events portraying defeats and weaknesses of the Filipino people. In the spirit of nationalism, how should you tackle them in the classroom? A. Present them as they are and tell the class to accept reality. B. Present the facts and use them as means to teach and inspire your class. C. Present the facts and express your feelings of regret. D. Present the facts including those people responsible for failures or those for those who contributed. Again, history books used in schools are replete with events portraying defeats and weaknesses of Filipino people, di ba? Divisive masyado ang Pinoy, nagtatrayduran, no? So, ano daw, bilang isang teacher, in the spirit of nationalism, how should you tackle them inside the classroom? A. Present them as they are and tell the class to accept reality. B. Present the facts and use them as means to teach and inspire your class. C. Present the facts and express your feelings of regret. D. Present the facts including those people responsible for failures or for those who contributed. Okay, so history book, nababasa naman natin yan, no? Si Bonifacio, kapwa Pilipino ang pumatay. Si Luna, kapwa Pilipino. Si Goyo, Trinaidor, ni Juanario Galot. Ang KKK, Trinaidor, ni Chodoro Patino. Napakarami pong istorya na hindi maganda ng pagkakawatak-watak at kahinaan ng mga Pilipino. So what to do? You present the facts. And then, use them as means to teach and inspire your class. We learn from our mistakes because according to Sir Ambet Ocampo, no, that history does not have a mind of its own. We are the ones who repeat history. So to learn from it, present the facts, use them as means to teach and inspire your class. Okay, letter B. Next item. Should an association of teachers obey a Supreme Court's decision even if it conflict with its interests and opinions? Again, should an association of teachers obey a Supreme Court's decision even if it conflict with its interests and opinions? A. No. B. Yes. C. Yes, provided they can make a bargain. D. No. As a minority group, they have the right to express their rejection. Okay. Okay, yes. Supreme Court na yan. That's the higher court, di ba? That's the highest court, I mean. So, papalag ka pa ba dyan? Yes, you should obey. Okay? Supreme Court is the final court to decide on things related to the constitutionality of a certain law or provisions. So letter B is the correct answer. Next. A teacher does not agree with the selective retention policy of the school and she openly talks it again. I mean, she openly talks it, talks about it in her classes. Is her behavior ethical? Again, a teacher daw does not agree with the selective retention policy sa kanyang pinagtuturoang eskwelahan. And she openly talks against it in her classes. Is it ethical? A. Yes, provided that she got the permission from her superior to talk against the policy. B. No, it is her duty to faithfully carry out even if it does, she does not agree. Letter C. No, in fact, she is quite confused and passes on her confusion to others. D. Yes, she is entitled to her opinion just as everybody is. So teachers, kapag po nasa teaching profession na kayo, always remember that our policies are centralized, no? So ibig sabihin kapag ipinasa na yan sa'yo, it is your duty, no, to faithfully carry it out kahit hindi mo siya gusto. Be objective. Okay? Yung mga pananaw mo is subjective yan. So yung in order, kasi yun yung under oath mo na gagampanan mo, dapat i-follow.